When I worked at Southern California Edison, one of the things that delighted me each year on January 6th was that a Latina coworker of mine would bring a special treat to share with everyone in our department to celebrate Dia de los Reyes, or Three Kings Day. She would share a traditional sweetbread called Rosca de Reyes. And if you're not familiar with this tradition in Mexican and Hispanic culture, on the morning of January 6th, the traditional date for celebrating the Epiphany, families would enjoy Rosca de Reyes for breakfast to commemorate the feast. The bread is an oval cake made in the shape of a crown, decorated with candied fruits on top, signifying jewels in the crown. Here comes the interesting part. A small plastic figurine representing the baby Jesus is hidden inside the cake prior to cutting it up. The person who finds baby Jesus in their slice, they are supposed to host a fiesta where they serve tamales on the Feast of the Presentation of the Lord, or known as Dia de la Candelaria, celebrated on February 2nd. Through this wonderful little tradition, the Christ child is made manifest, as he was in the first Epiphany. And when we find Jesus, when he is revealed to us, what happens next? The Lord calls us on mission. So it is very fitting that the person who finds baby Jesus in their slice of bread is called into service to make Christ manifest by being Christ to others and serving them. In our gospel story from Matthew, the Magi were in search of a newborn king to pay him homage. They brought the Christ child gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. All these gifts were of great value. The gift of gold was considered a worthy gift for a king and thus signified Jesus's kingship. Frankincense, an expensive and very aromatic fragrance, was primarily used for worship and thus signified Jesus's priesthood. Myrrh was an essential oil used in preparation for burial. It pointed to Jesus' role as prophet and that he would sacrifice on the cross for us. As we know, prophets are not always appreciated as truth tellers and often suffer for their calling. Together, the three gifts brought by the Magi signify that Jesus is priest, prophet, and king. When each of us was baptized, we were anointed with chrism oil to signify that as baptized faithful, as members of the body of Christ, we too live the vocations, are to live the vocations of priest, prophet, and king in our daily lives. We may not wear a Roman collar, we may not experience prophetic visions, and we may not wear a royal crown, but by virtue of our baptism and confirmation, we participate in the church's mission to sanctify, to teach, and to govern. So how can we be priests, prophets, and kings? We accomplish the priestly action of sanctification by frequently receiving the sacraments, to participating fully in the Mass, through devotion to prayer, to sacrificial giving, and through charitable works. Some questions that we can ask ourselves are, how much time do we spend in prayer outside of Sunday Mass? How often do we as a family pray together? And what are we doing to show sacrificial love of God and of neighbor on a regular basis? We can be prophets by spreading the gospel messages in those places where we live, work, and play. Bishops and priests are primarily exercise their prophetic office through liturgy, through the sacraments. So it mostly falls on lay people to share the faith outside of those settings. Do we ever talk about our faith experiences with friends or coworkers to help lead them to Christ? How often do we lend a listening ear and a comforting word to our fellow parishioners who might be going through a difficult time and need their own faith bolstered? Do we teach our children what it is to be Catholic, or do we rely on the church to do it all for us? We are kings in the way that we govern our households, protect our families from evil influences, how we spend our time and our money, and model our Catholic Christian values. What kind of TV shows, movies, and other entertainment do we watch in our homes? Do they reflect our values as people of God? How much time do we dedicate to nurturing our faith and building relationships with others versus making more money or individual pursuits that satisfy our personal pleasure? How do we treat others through the language and tone of voice that we use? As we begin 2022 and make resolutions for the new year, let us ponder how we can be an epiphany in that way that we manifest Jesus as priest, prophet, and king. In this new year, what will we do differently in our daily life to bring glory to God? Each of us, like the Magi, has been drawn to the light, arriving at this place where Christ dwells. There, lying in the creche, is the baby Jesus. How shall we pay him homage? What demonstrations of faith and love are we prepared to give him as our newborn king? Will we share the good news of the Christ child with others, or will we keep his coming into the world a secret? Let us be like that bright star in the night sky that points to Jesus. O star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Amen.